up, guys? Today I'll show you features that will elevate your customer service. Let's go. Tip number one, always use the room inventory feature. I will show you how it works. We go to the rooms section, and here is the room inventory tab. In this room inventory tab, you can create all inventory that is associated with your hotel. So, for example, whether your room includes bathroom or does it have a mini bar, all this information can be later on pulled in the reservation screen so that your receptionist can quickly answer even the most demanding questions of your customer. If someone asks you, does this room have a mini bar? Well, you don't have to remember it. Of course, it's nice to remember everything, but it's not as simple in the real life. But you just can have a simple glance at the reservation screen and you know it instantly. And it will be also used when you search for the perfect room for your customer, and I'll show it in a minute. So to create a room inventory, we click Add, we type the name, and we click Apply. And how to assign inventory to each room? Well, we go back to the Rooms tab, we edit a room. I'll just do it for the double room group. Edit, Inventory, and here you just select which inventory should apply to this room. Okay, while you're in the rooms territory, there is one more tip I want to show you. If you want to be able to answer even more demanding questions from your customer, you can also add room descriptions. How to do it? You edit a room here, and in this place, you can write, for example, the most important aspects of your room or answers to questions that are often asked regarding this room. So you can write, for example, that it has a sea view. So it's not simple to remember everything, as I mentioned before. So you can do it here, and it will immensely help your receptionist to tackle your customers faster and more efficiently. So if you write it here, and we go to the reservation screen, just a second. Okay, and look. In the upper left corner, we have both the inventory and the description. So as you can see, you can fit quite a few information that is essential for your receptionist to handle everyone faster. The next feature will help you to improve control over your front desk and over the reservations that are managed in KWHotel and in your hotel as well. So what about the canceled bookings? If you think about cancelled bookings, there can be quite a few reasons why they are cancelled, which means erased in KWHotel. If you have a standard or pro version and you synchronize with booking portals, cancellations can happen automatically. Yes, if someone cancels a reservation in booking.com, it will disappear from the calendar. But even if it disappears, it doesn't mean it's not able to be pulled again from the KWHotel. You always have it stored in the history. You can also delete a reservation because it was made incorrectly, or the customer has simply canceled, called you and canceled the reservation. And there are more reasons. Perhaps someone is not honest with you. It can also happen, trust me. So this is why we have created the canceled reservations option, and you can find it in the tools and canceled bookings. So here, let me just show you. I will create a reservation quickly. Let's just write for Mariusz, and I have to save it to delete it. So let's save it. Look, remember when I told you that there will be a colorful border if you have a rate plan reservation? Well, this is the red border I was talking about, because this is a reservation created for the standard rate plan. And look, here is the delete reservation option. If I click it, it asks me what is the reason for deleting this booking. So I can just use one of these options. I can also click other. I can write some more information. Customer called and said he won't come here. And then I click yes, cancel this reservation, and it disappeared. But what if I want to restore it because he called me again and said, Mariusz, I will come to your hotel. Sorry for the problem. So we go back to tools, we click cancel bookings. And as you can see, it was for today. You can always sort or filter out these dates. It was here. I can, for example, see what was the purpose for the cancellation. You can just highlight it here and it will be displayed. Customer called and said he won't come here. And here I can also restore it or I can preview it. So I don't have to restore it to the calendar, block availability and so on. But I can see what was there, what amounts were collected, what documents were issued and so on. But let's assume I want to restore it. I just click here. I confirm. Reservation was restored. And in a moment, I have to close it. And as you can see, reservation was restored. Now, there are moments in your hotel when you have to refurbish some rooms and they are not available to bookings. They are not available to walk-ins and so on. So if you want to avoid those misunderstandings with the guests when your receptionist forgets about refurbishment and sells the room anyway, there is this option to include the so-called out-of-order reservation. And I'll show you how it works. Let's assume that all these rooms will be being refurbished for 7 days. I can select them here on the calendar and I click the Add Out-of-Order option. Now, as you can see, it has already populated everything as I intended. I can also write here why am I closing this room? Because you can have other reasons. It doesn't have to be room refurbishment. And we click Save. And this causes those gray reservations to appear. And if you are synchronized with booking portals, this will also block availability online, so you don't have to worry about overbookings. And also it will show your receptionist on the calendar whenever he is called or there is a walk-in in your reception. He can always take a look at the calendar. And also if he searches for the room for the reservation, I will show this option in a moment. It's the next one on my list, okay? Well, if he searches for the perfect room for your customer, he'll also don't see it on the results tab. Now let's use this room inventory we have just created and help our receptionist to find the perfect room for our customer. So to do it, we use the Find Room option. If we click it, we can select some criteria and KWHotel will search for the perfect result. So, first of all, what room inventory should be included? So we ask our guest and he says, I need a bathroom included. So I click bathroom. As you can see, the results have been already narrowed down. Then I can limit my search to a specific room group. For example, I ask my customer how many adults will come, how many people will be included in the reservation. He says there will be 2 people. So in this case, I can limit it to my double room group. And then I can just ask him what is the term that you are interested in, what are the dates. And he says from the 17th to 18th of May. And I click search. And when I click search, I can see there are 3 rooms that meet these criteria. And if I decide for room number 6, let's say, I just click book. Let's just wait. Okay. And here I can populate the data of my customer. Okay. How can you find a customer in KWHotel? So this is quite simple. You have an option, find customer. You click it. And here all you have to do is to write the first 4 letters of the name. If someone has a name that has only 3 letters, all you have to do is write it like Mar and click space. And this will also find me in the database. So I write Mariusz. I'm waiting here and I just double click it. And I have opened my customer. And since we are here, I can also show you 2 amazing features. As you can see, my customer window, it has this green highlight on the bottom and on the top. And this means I am a regular customer. So I'm someone that is very welcome in this hotel. And if I am not welcome, I can always select that I am blacklisted, which always gives you a great hint for your receptionist that the person who just appeared should be really, really, monitored for her actions. And you can always include the reason for blacklisting or selecting the customer who is your VIP. You can always write it in the comments. So, customer was arguing with the staff. Okay, or customer was violent, or customer didn't pay and left the hotel, and so on. So if I leave it here, I'll show you in a moment where is it shown in the reservation screen, because even though it's nice to have it here, it wouldn't help you if you open the reservation, you write the customer down, take him from the database, and you wouldn't see it, yes? So it would be a problem, but it is very, very directly shown in the reservation screen. And the second thing before we move to the reservation screen is the ability to give a discount to your customer. So if you write it here in the discount section and you type when is the discount valid, so let's say I shouldn't really be discounting a blacklisted customer, so perhaps I should change it. Let's make him regular VIP, okay? It's more realistic now. So until the end of this year, I, Mariusz, will receive a 10% discount, and you don't have to remember about it. It will happen automatically. And now we will go to a new reservation. So let's create another reservation for Mariusz. I write it here, okay. I click, and as you can see, you can immediately tell that I am a regular customer. And also, my 10% discount has been automatically added to the reservation. Okay, we've searched for the perfect room. We've searched for the ideal customer, or not so ideal if it's blacklisted. What about searching for new reservations? For example, someone walks into your hotel and says, I have a reservation that and that number, or for that and that name. So you have quite a few options again. So first of all, we have this find reservation button. So if your customer tells you the reservation number that he received on the booking confirmation, you can type it here. And how can I know what is the ID of the given reservation? Let's open this. And it's here, reservation number 8. So this is the KWHotel's ID of the reservation. This ID cannot be modified. You cannot restart the numeration, you cannot alter it. This is not possible. So I can also just approach this reservation here, hover my mouse cursor over here, and I can see reservation number 8. So option number 1, customer tells me I have reservation number 8. I click find, then the reservation will open. Okay. The second option, if I click here, my customer can be a customer from booking.com or other online booking portals. So he can tell me the online reservation number, and this reservation number also will search for the reservation. Let's do it here. So I will later discuss this whole reservation screen in detail, but right now we will focus only on the reservation number. So if I go to the other tab, I have the online reservation number here. If you synchronize with the online booking portals in KWHotel, this reservation number will be filled in automatically. You can also write it on your own if you are doing it manually. For example, in KWHotel Free, you can do it on your own. So let's say it was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I click save. And let's open the find reservation feature. And I ask my customer, what is your online reservation number, sir? And he says 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And if I click find, Just a moment. If I click find, it also opens correctly. And there is also, you also have the option to limit it by single and group reservations. And you can also use date until which it should search. But there's also a great bluish tip here. So if you have people who have paid by bank transfer and they sent you a payment confirmation, you have a PDF, let's say, you can also search for the reservation using their PDF or Word document. And this is great because if you receive a payment as a payment confirmation PDF, you can always open it. You can quickly search for the reservation that you have to put this payment to. And it can happen very, very quickly. So let me show it to you. Let's assume that this beautiful, beautifully crafted Word document is a PDF or Word payment confirmation. Oh, of course, it shouldn't be Word because it shouldn't be, okay? It should be a PDF. But it also works for Word documents. So if you leave this Find Reservation tab opened, it has to be opened to work. You go back to your document, you select the phrase that you want to search for, and you click Control Q. I just did it. And let's go back to my KW Hotel. Voila, it opened the reservation instantly. And now I can just type the amount that was paid. For example, it was 150, okay? And you did it in a matter of seconds.